Greetings to everybody in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. On the 28th of January, I went to the doctor to do HIV tests. When the results came back, they said I'm HIV positive.
And then January,
on the 30th of January,
another doctor who confirmed I'm positive.
I went to another doctor to confirm if really I'm positive.
The results did have a positive.
The results came back being positive again. I stayed with those results and I never told my family. Until one day my mom called me to tell me that she's from a certain church in Tembisa. She said to me that the pastor is a real man of God and one day you must go there when you've got time. Indeed, one day I took a day off from work and I came to this place. When I came here, Apostle called the people who were positive so that he can pray for them. When I came forward here, he asked me, why am I agreeing that I am HIV positive? I told him that this is what they told me at the doctor. He said to me that you are not positive, you are negative. He prayed for me and he said, tomorrow go and do the test again. Yesterday I'm from the doctor. The results are back, they say I'm HIV negative. I thank God for that. By the miracle he has shown unto me. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I would like to thank God for what he has done. I had a challenge on Sunday. When I woke up in the morning, the child was having high fever.
On Sunday morning when I woke up, the child was having high fever.
So I ended up telling my daughter not to come to church and stay home with the child.
I told my daughter that she must not come to church, she must stay at home with the child.
When I went back home, the child was still having fever. Little did I know that the fever will result to his death. Late before we go to bed, I saw something strange in his face. And I ended up knowing I have anointing water and a calendar. I used 1.5 bottles. And I took a calendar of Charis. I wrapped around his body until it was destroyed. And I kept on calling the name Jesus. But the child was not responding. It was impossible to give him anointing water. He's only 3 years old, but you cannot, but that time you were not able to open his mouth. So I ended up making sure that even if I can hurt him, I have to open the mouth for the anointing water to touch his tongue. Believe it or not, he rose again. I ended up coming to church at that time at night. It was past 10 to 11. The reason why I came to church, I need a confirmation that he will never die when we were asleep. So I met one of the prophets of Charis. Indeed, he assured that he will never die again. He told me that the reason why this is happening, it was the plan of Satan to shame me. And I thank the Heavenly Father for his life.
Amen.
Clap hands for Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Okay. You are following. Say, I'm following. Can you say, I'm following? Speak with confidence. I'm going to be a next testifier. You are granted. You are granted that way. God bless you. You know, this thing of, I don't want to talk too much about it because sometimes when we stand one place talking about what has happened, but also we want to know because we have been given things to use. There are times where your prayer will be finished. You see, when you see strange things, you pray, you find that you need anointing water. Look here, she rubbed the calendar. We never said we can use it for something like that. We say, write it on it. And she rubbed it until the calendar was finished. But in her heart, there's issue of what, anointing water. Mama, tell us, was the child truly dead?
He was really dead.
He was dead.
Yes,
no breathing, cold.
It's like there is this thing, once you hang yourself, you release at the back.
Oh, she, okay, yes. I was gone, eh?
Yes, yes.
And when you tried to open the mouth,
it was difficult, it was impossible. It was
blind.
I couldn't even put my hand inside. Just to open the mouth, it was difficult.
What tells you to say, calendar? Because maybe we're supposed to have been finished there. I've used calendar, but nothing. What tells you to say, let me take anointing water?
I don't know, I was having these voices.
Can you hear them now?
I was hearing voices telling me what to do. And I knew by that time it was not myself doing it. Because I've never prayed for anybody in my life.
So you can hear that. Amen. Automatically when you've got anointing water, you're a prophet of yourself. Okay, congratulations. Thank you.
Amen.
God bless you. Thank you. Hallelujah. Testimony of HIV. Come, my sister. I was very much concerned.
Okay,
how we are praying for people of HIV here. You people can't believe.
Come,
God can heal them that way. Because the first thing is to call them to come running. If you are HIV here, run forward. You can see when she's running, coming by faith. Can you see that? And from there, say, you are here, go and test.
I
ask her how we pray for her. My sister, now you are HIV negative. Now.
You're not only HIV negative.
Are you married?
No.
You want to marry now?
Yeah, I think I'm ready.
Eh?
Yeah.
You want to marry who? You don't have anybody?
Yeah.
Eh?
Yeah.
So, you people here now, you can do that.
When
somebody wants to marry you, whether it's from the church or no,
I mean,
come together and say, please, let's go for a checkup first. And before we see the pastor. Are you hearing me? So that we pray for you. We don't want issue of, no, now you are standing like this and you are hiding it. The Bible says, when you hide your sin, you will never prosper. You tell this way, not because you are believing in doctors. You say, okay, please, can we go for checkup? You are not trying to say you don't trust this person. You say, no, if you want to see me before the issue of the wedding on
Lobola,
you can come to me and say, we want to marry, whatever, this and that. And then, if I look at you, I found, there is ding-dong here. I'll allow you to go for check-up. But when I found that you don't have anything, I will just say, okay, come now, you just need my counseling.
You know, talk
of when do you want to marry? I bless you, just like you. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
So that you don't accuse each other. The moment you want to marry someone, and then already yourself, already somebody can be afraid of you. But you are free. I'm not seeing HIV at all. If you come with someone, I will just say, for the sake of that one not to have fear, go and check. But if it's someone here you have never, you're coming here, I would just say, no.
Oh,
sometimes I call people, I say, sorry, I want to see you. And if there's no HIV, there's no need for me to see you. I'm sure you understand what I'm trying to say. There's no issue of saying, please come here, see there, you people here, HIV, so I'm seeing HIV, can I pray with you? This and that. So, God loves you. So, to you, I'm giving you license that you can marry. There are many people there here who want to marry. And there's no HIV on you. Your curves will come back now. You remember you were having curves?
Yes.
You were having curves, they were finished because of HIV. HIV doesn't respect curves.
HIV, I don't pity
curves. But your curves are coming back now. You will see, to prove that you are healed, you will see yourself gaining weight, curves coming back, your color also coming back. Because you used to have some things inside your mouth here.
True.
So those things now, they are finished now since you are healed. Your curves are coming.
I don't
need to talk about HIV again. So, what do you want for this? What we shall do?